Welcome to video lecture. Today we will talk about crystallization and evaporation to dryness. Let's start. What is crystallization? Principle: separation of a soluble solid from a solution. What is crystal? The definite geometrical shape of a solid is called its crystal. The process of making crystals is called crystallization. Crystallization is based on two methods: cold method and hot method. So let's see what is cold method and hot method. What is cold method? Prepare a saturated solution, filter the solution, place the filtrate in a cold atmosphere. After many hours, few crystals will form. After that, you have to filter to separate crystals, wash it with distilled water, and then dry it between the folds of filter paper. Now what is hot method? You have to prepare the saturated solution, again filter the solution, place the filtrate on flame in evaporating dish until crystallization. Cool it, filter it, and wash it with distilled water, and then dry it between folds of filter paper. So the major difference is that in cold method you have to place the filtrate in a cold atmosphere for many hours, but in hot method you have to place the filtrate in evaporating dish in order to obtain the crystals. Now what is saturated solution? A saturated solution is a chemical solution containing the maximum concentration of a solute dissolved in a solvent. The additional solute will not dissolve in a saturated solution. Process of crystallization: dissolve impure solid in water, filter to remove any of the impurities present in that solution, heat solution until it is saturated. When the solution is saturated, leave it to cool and crystallize. In the end, filter to collect the crystals, wash the crystals with little cold distilled water to remove impurities between a few sheets of filter paper. So this is the general procedure of crystallization process. In this picture you can see the crystals of pure copper sulfate. Cold method, basically it is a slow process but very suitable method for making large size crystals. Second point is that suitable for make heat unstable crystals. Hot method, do not heat the crystal till dryness. Why? The crystals may be decomposed. Decompose mean breakdown. Water of crystallization may lose if present. Third point, a powder compound is obtained instead of crystals. What is evaporation to dryness? By using the process of evaporation to dryness, we can also get the crystals. Basically, it is used to obtain soluble solids from solution by heating the solution until all the water has boiled off. So what are the drawbacks of this process? Number one, solid obtained by evaporation to dryness is not always pure. It is not the best method for those substances which decomposes on strong heating, such as sugar, carbon and copper to sulfate crystals. So for these substances we will use the process of crystallization. So there are two processes for obtaining crystals or for obtaining soluble solids. First is evaporation to dryness, second is crystallization. In evaporation to dryness, of course you have to heat the solution until all the solvent evaporates and you will only get the solute. So the drawback is there must be chance of having impurities. While crystallization, you have to prepare a saturated solution, allow the solution to cool in order to form a crystals, and in the end you have to dry the crystal by pressing between the sheets of filter paper. How can we get sugar from sugarcane juice? Which process we will use? Crystallization process. Importance: to purify substances such as purification of drugs. Second point is that desalination of seawater. What is desalination mean? Removal of salt from seawater. Why crystallization occur? Well, solubility of most solutes decrease as temperature decrease. When solution cools, solution cannot hold more solute, so the extra solute separate as pure crystals. Concept map. Crystallization is a purification and separation technique. We'll prefer crystallization if solid decomposes on strong heating. Crystallization is used to separate soluble solid from a solution. In crystallization process, we will get pure crystals, such as copper 2 sulfate crystals. Any queries? Thank you. Goodbye.